Hey guys, welcome back to the Second Time Lucky Mining channel. In today's video, we are going to go ahead and build AI Rig, or Proof of Useful Rig number 3. Now, for those of you that are new to the channel, I am super excited about AI and Proof of Useful Work. Flux introduced me to the concept, but after watching their Cypherpunk event last week, I am, safe to say, a little bit disappointed in their progress or the lack of showing us anything really, but that is not stopping me learning and trying new things. And for those of you that are new to the channel, I've been playing with these type of AI proof of useful rigs probably for the last 2 months. So I've been using the Mining King's guide, and for those of you that don't know, he's got a great guide around setting it up. I've made a couple of tweaks to that, but you know, if you're interested, go check out his video and his membership to get access to, you know, his guide. But I will do it slightly different. I've got my own spin of that, and I'm going to take you guys along the journey. Now, what the hell are we going to do in this video? Well, I'll take you through my journey as I build up this specific AI rig. Yes, it's number 3, so I've done it a couple of times, so I've learned a couple of lessons in the process, but let's have a look at what am I going to be building in and which components am I going to be using. Now, starting with the power supply, what I'll be going with is an EVGA 1600 watt platinum power supply, and as you can see, this one still has got the foam around it, so it's pretty new. I bought this one, full disclosure, brand new specifically for this build. It was on a discount, was $150 discounted. I already have two of these that I'm using in my other two AI rigs, and they have been going super well. I haven't had an issue with it. I already had an issue with a power supply that I built with my Threadripper machine. Again, for those of you that didn't follow the video, I already had a PC that I've tried for the last 2 months. As soon as I added multiple GPUs, I started having issues where the rig crashed. I swapped out the power supply. Yes, again, that is overkill, but all my issues disappeared. It's been rock solid, it's been quiet. So I really haven't had issues with these EVGA power supplies. Again, you know, you should be using whatever, if you're a miner, whatever mining power supplies that you got around. But something that I've realized with AI or proof of useful work is the people that rent your machine, they are going to hit it full bore. And when I mean full bore, they will hit full TDP on your GPU and your CPU. So you just need to make sure that you can deliver that power at full TDP and that you can cool the system. And again, you know, what I'm using to cool the system, we'll talk about in some of these other components that I've got. Talking about cooling, I will be building my proof of useful work rig in this specific case here. So let me move this power supply over and then bring it forward like this. So this is the Fantex case. It's an Etho Pro 2 Silver Edition. It's absolutely massive. And again, I'll show you guys better pictures as soon as I unbox and actually build into it. And again, I'll take you guys on that journey. But the main reason why I chose choose this specific case here is it is absolutely massive. It's got fans everywhere. It's got fans on the side. And then probably the most important thing specifically for me, and again, lessons that I've learned out of my other two rigs, is the PCIe slots that it actually supports. Now, this specific case supports 11, and a typical ATX case, or even the 4U server case that I've got in the back that I have my Epic in at the moment, only supports, I don't know, anything from 4 to 7 PCIe slots. So this supports a lot of space. Obviously, it won't fit in my server rack, but that's not the end of the story. I'm going to try build it in this and then compare it against the other two cases that I have. And again, I've got a normal ATX case, and then I've got a 4U server case for my Epic. But the idea is here that I will try and slot at least 4 GPUs into this case. So that's at least what I'm going to try and do throughout this video. Now, sticking with the cooling theme, what we will be using to cool our CPU is this Noctua, what is it? NHU9TR4. So this is a 4U cooler that's got a fan on. I've actually used this specific cooler in my other Epic rig, and it's been fantastic. I really don't have issues around noise, and that's the main reason why I wanted this. It's going to be in my home. This specific one I'm definitely going to put in the garage, so the noise probably doesn't matter that much, but I'll be making use of this. What I've seen, at least with my 32 core Epic, I've got a 7532, so that's Gen 2 AMD Epic, that it's managed to cool, that only has 32 cores, and I've seen a person mine on my CPU and it's been cold. So I really don't have any issues. The max temperature that I've seen so far on my other Epic has been probably around the mid 70s is the highest that I've seen. But again, depending on the workload, the time of the day and the season, that might differ. But I really have had good success with the Noctua cooler. Yes, there's lots of other options, and I would encourage you to have a look at the other options. For me, I'm a little bit biased. I love Noctua fans. They are quiet. They are reliable. Yes, they are a little bit more expensive, but I'm happy to pay the premium for the product that I get at the end of the day. Now, in terms of hard drives, what I'll be going with is a NVMe SSD. This is specifically a Gen 4 NVMe SSD. So what I have here is the XPG 2TB drive. Again, I've got this exact same drive in my other Epic Rig, and it's been performing quite well. It does about 4,500 megatransfers or megabytes transferred or read or write speeds. Again, I haven't had an issue. I find the installation process a little bit easier when you have only specifically one drive. Otherwise, you need to do mapping and partitioning and LVMs and all sorts of stuff like that. Again, I've tried that in my first Threadripper machine where I had, I can't remember, a 4TB hard drive that I tried to map to the Docker folder. Again, you can specifically do that. So, you know, you don't have to use one drive for your AI rig. You can do more than one. Specifically, I'll be setting this up on VAST, at least as a start. And the installation process, at least in my opinion, it's easier if you just do the one drive. And again, that's what I'm going to go with on my other rig. It's been going well, specifically this one. So I'm going to stick with it and see how I go. If it degrades or the performance becomes worse, I'll try something different. I've been looking at U.2 drives, but at least I'll stick with what I know for the next couple of rigs. Now, in terms of platform here, and let me just move the cooler around, what I'll be going with, and you can see here from the Chinese language here, I've bought a secondhand Epic, and together with a Supermicro motherboard. And again, why am I going with Epic and why am I going with Supermicro? Well, I've done that before. So my secondary kit at the back, you're probably hearing a little bit humming away, again, is a AMD Epic. I went with the second gen. Again, that was the 32, if I remember correctly. It's a 32 core, but what I'll be going with this time around is slightly bit better. So I'll be going with at least Zen 3 architecture, and I will be going with the 7713. So that's a 64 core, 128 threads. What I'll be doing is, as you can see here, I've got four sticks of ECC memory. And if I can remember correctly, when I bought this, this is the 2933 megatransfer speeds. One of these DIMMs, these are ECC memory. This specific DIMM here, or all four of them, is ECC, but it's 64 gigs. So obviously four sticks here would give me 256 gigs of RAM. I went with only four sticks because I wanted to have a look and see the memory consumption that I will see. I already have 128 gigs in my other Epic rig, and at least the workloads that I've seen so far, nobody has come close to 128 gigs. I have seen on my Threadripper that they've used up to, let's call it 92 gigabytes, depending again on the workload and what is happening. But I haven't seen more than that, to be honest. So I'm going with 256. And then again, if I need more, there's actually 8 slots on this motherboard. So I can go ahead and buy 4 more in case I needed to go to a 0.5 TB of memory. Again, we will see, depending on the workload, if that is ever needed. If it is, I will just get the extra sticks here. And again, in terms of motherboard here, what I went with is, again, something similar what I've got at the back that is away here. And, you know, I will eventually open it up here. It's still in the wrapping here, but this is the H12 Supermicro SSL. So this will be PCIe Gen 4. So again, that's the the main reason why I went to this. The H11s is a little bit cheaper, but that's PCIe Gen 3. So I went with Gen 4. I went with Gen 4 at the back as well. Again, it helps me, let's call it future-proof, but makes my rig a little bit more desirable for other people. Again, I've got the Gen 1 Threadripper that's on Gen 3. So again, I'm having a look and see, you know, what works and what doesn't work for me. Again, why am I going with Epic? And then why the hell am I going with so much RAM? The big thing that I've noticed with AI is the amount of PCIe lanes. So again, Gen 3 or my first Gen Threadripper had 64 Gen 3 lanes. AMD Epic has 128 lanes, and this specific one has Gen 4 lanes. So the more lanes you have, the more throughput there is specifically for the GPU. So that's why I'm going with either Threadripper or AMD Epic. That doesn't mean that you can't use your desktop or any Intel machines for that matter, at least the Intel server machines, they also have a lot of lanes. Why I'm not specifically using desktops or normal motherboards, well, I don't have a lot of them laying around. I wasn't specifically a massive CPU miner, so I don't really have any of those consumer grade motherboards just laying around that I specifically can use. Now, the other thing, and again, you know, I'm a big advocate of using what you already have. Don't go and buy stuff that you now need to go and ROI on. But the other thing that you just need to take into consideration, if you are using normal consumer hardware, you can't really go more than one and potentially two GPUs on normal consumer grade. And the big reason for that is the amount of lanes that you have at your disposal is not a lot. And the throughput or the amount of lanes that you give the GPU matters for these AI or proof of useful work workloads. Lastly, let's have a look at the GPU as I pack this away. Now, what I'm encouraging and what I definitely suggest you do is go ahead and use exactly what you have. And there's lots of different places that you can have a look and see what is the most profitable or what is the most in demand. Profitable, I don't know if that is necessarily the best term when looking at these type of things. Depending on the AI workload, some GPUs are just more in demand. And what I see is the most in demand GPUs is obviously 4090s and 3090s. Why? Well, they are absolute powerhouses. They can do most AI workloads and they've got a lot of VRAM, right? So they've got 24 gigs of VRAM. But what I'm going to do is slightly different. Is I'm going to have a look, and as I get this retailer Kohl's bag here, so what I did is I bought most of the stuff, and I continue to do it. Again, if you follow the channel, I buy almost everything secondhand, and that's no exception here with GPUs. I think I've only, out of the 50 plus GPUs that I have, I only bought three brand new. But looking at this, I'm going with the A5000. And the big reason why I'm going with the A5000, or one of the big reasons why I'm going with this, is if you have a look at that, it only has one 8-pin connector. So what that does mean is the maximum power draw of a A5000 is 230 watts. Now, I already have one at the back there. It's been great. That's just what I'm going with. Again, why one 8-pin connector? It's nice and slim, as you can see here, and it can fit into 4U server cases, which again, what I've got at the back there, and I can fit multiple into this case. Why? Because, you know, it's nice and slim. It only takes up two PCIe slots and it doesn't pull a lot of power, and it's got 24 gigs of ECC memory. So that's some of the reasons as to why, you know, I'm actually paying a little bit more for a secondhand A5000 compared with a 3090, because this is sort of the equivalent of a 3090. I can definitely get some 3090s cheaper than what I can get a A5000 for, but I really like the form factor, the wattage, the memory that's in this specific GPU. So that's why I'm specifically going with it. Again, I'm not saying you should be doing that. It's definitely not the most profitable, not the smartest thing to do. You should be using what you have, but that's specifically why I'm going with the A5000. And again, We will see how this all pans out, if it does pan out as something good or something bad. Again, I will share with you guys. But enough of talking about all of the components. I'm sure you guys are bored about that about now. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to build out at least the motherboard, the CPU, the RAM, the SSD, and one GPU. I'm just gonna build it on this box just to make sure that everything boots, it sees all the memory, it sees the SSD, and then install an OS. So this is what it looks like once I've installed it and got it up and running outside of the box here. And what I generally do, as I can see here, is I like just to make sure that every component is working and it's picking up correctly here. And you can see here, it's already booted into installing Ubuntu. So I'm just going to stop it there and not sort of show you guys all of those steps again. It's really easy. There's lots of guides out there to install Ubuntu. But what I just wanted to show you guys here, some of the lessons that I've learned here is, one of the things is, as you can see here, I'm making use of this VGA port here. So these server motherboards has got a VGA port here specifically if we wanted to see what's going on behind the scenes. The other thing here is there's actually two NICs here, so don't go and plug it into the IPMI. So this one specifically here is the IPMI, so just make sure you never plug it in to that. Otherwise you should be golden. And again, what I'm going to do now is just install Ubuntu outside of the box specifically like this. And then once I can see everything is hunky-dory, I will then go ahead and move it to the other case. And by the way, what you're seeing behind here is one of my Octaminers that's got 3070s in. And here's my 4U case that currently has got the other Epic that I've got with an A5000 in here. So again, let me go ahead and build it into the other computer and quickly install Ubuntu. Okay, so I've managed to put the bare bones back into the Fantex case, and I'll show you guys sort of what it looks like and what I'm going to do next. Now, as you guys can see, this case is absolutely massive here. I'll try and change the camera angle slightly, but as you can see here, I've got the Threadripper, the AMD Epic in there. I've got the one A5000 in there. And what you also can see is all of the different space that I specifically have got here. Now, what I need to go and do is find spots for another three A5000. So I'm thinking at least this one here, that one there, and potentially the one right next to that. So I'll see how close I can get it and is it going to fit. But one of the main reasons why I specifically went with this case is the amount of PCIe brackets. And I'll see if I can change the camera angle a little bit slightly, but as you can see here at the bottom, there's still lots of space for PCIe connectors. So what I'm thinking is taking a Gen 4 PCIe extender and then mounting another GPU here. So that's the sort of the idea that, you know, I can go ahead and add multiple GPUs. So I just need to go and have a look and see what specifically fits. Now, what I've done is I've installed Ubuntu and I've checked everything is working, it's picking up the GPU. So the idea next is I need to go and just slot in the GPUs, run it, make sure it works, and then continue on to the next one. What I'm also going to do is install some of these fans. I just need to go and have a look and see, you know, what sort of makes best sense. Now, what will happen is the A5000 will dump air through there. So what I'm thinking is just pushing air through the GPUs like this. There's also another bracket, something similar to this, that I can mount specifically here, and that can extract heat out or push cool air in. So those are some of the options specifically with this Fantex case. Now, as you guys can see, I still have a lot of work that I need to go ahead and do to find at least space for the other three GPUs within the case. The case is definitely big enough. It's just the PCIe connectors to make sure that there's enough space. And in hindsight, a typical GPU frame or double GPU frame, typically what you've seen in Panda's video or Red Panda Mining's video, is probably a better fit. But I'm still content on this case. I love the size, and I'm sure it's going to work. I just need to make sure that I've got enough cooling and that all of the GPUs are working and that I can do the necessary installations and get this rig listed so I can start earning at least some dollars. But that's it for this video, guys. If you've liked the video, please like it. If you didn't, please specify in the comments what you would like me to change. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.